What's up, everybody? Hello, and welcome into another movie reaction, but more specifically, welcome into October, which is such a fun time in the reaction space because I do feel like most channels, and I can include myself with this, we like to take the opportunity to kind of branch off a little bit and watch some scary movies, horrors, thrillers, or fun movies that tie into Halloween in a way. And for myself, I wanted to have a theme this month, but I wanted it to be like ultra specific. So I decided to watch the Ghostbusters series, all 5 movies. Those reactions will come out on the channel throughout the month of October, in between other things. So if you're not a fan of this series, don't worry. It's not the only thing I'm uploading in October, but I'm excited for this. I always get people really surprised when I say that I've never seen the Ghostbusters movies before. I do get asked if I know the theme song, and yes, I have heard the theme song a bajillion times. I'm well aware that you call the Ghostbusters when there is something strange in your neighborhood. But I don't know anything about the story. I do know that Bill Murray is in the first one, which I'm watching today, the one from 1984. And I do know that Paul Rudd is in one of the last movies, either the most recent one or the one before it. Can't remember which one. That's about it for actors. That's all I know. I'm super excited to get into this. This has been recommended a ton ever since I started the channel. Lots of suggestions have come through for this, but very much have to shout out one of my longest viewers and Patreon supporters who has been pushing for this for quite some time. So you're welcome, Tyler. As you can see, I've set up my light wall behind me to be on brand for the movie. We've got ghosts flying around back there. And the last thing I have to say is Patreon is the place for you if you prefer the full-length watch-alongs over the edited versions. You'll find them for all of the Ghostbusters films, plus everything else I've reacted to on the channel, plus so much more that I haven't even edited for YouTube yet. My tiers are pretty inexpensive. You get a ton in exchange for that. So if you want to support, come on over there. And with that, I am ready to do some ghost bustin', or rather, it's not me doing it, but I'll be watching others do it. So with that, let's go ahead and press play. Sexual content in Ghostbusters? The fuck? I could spend hours in a library like this. Ooh. Well, why are the ghosts making a mess though? Watch a book just like fly out and hit her in the head. Who are you gonna call? Ghostbusters. Everyone knows the song, right?
I want you to tell me what you think it is.
Square.
Good guess, but wrong. Clear your head. Tell me what you think it is.
Is it a star?
It is a star.
Very good. That's great.
Think hard.
There's a doctor on the door? What kind of doctor is he?
Circle.
Okay. What is it?
Figure eight.
That's 5 for 5. You can't see these, can
no.
you?
I don't like this.
You only have 75 more.
Oh my gosh. Only 75.
Just a couple of wavy lines.
Sorry. This isn't your lucky day.
I know.
That was close enough.
Get a little tired of this.
You volunteered, didn't you?
I'm studying the effect of negative reinforcement on ESP ability.
It's pissing me off.
Well, then maybe my theory is correct.
You can keep the $5.
You may as well get used to that.
Do you think I have it, Dr. Venkman?
You're no fluke, Jennifer.
This is it.
Will you excuse me for a second?
I'm right in the middle of something, Ray.
A jump and slap.
10 people witnessed a free-floating, full-torso, vaporous apparition.
We're close on this one. I can feel it.
Hope we can clear this up quickly and quietly.
Let's not rush things. We don't even know what you have yet.
I already love, like, the line delivery from him specifically. Oh. It's quite the pile.
Metrical book stacking. Just like the Philadelphia man's turbulence of 1947.
The what?
About telekinetic activity. Look at this mess.
What is the goop?
Oh. Ah. Come on. Oh.
I wonder what that actually is, though.
Egon, your mucus.
Jeez. Okay. I don't even know what he's using.
It's here.
A full torso apparition.
So what do we do? Could you come over here and talk to me for a second, please? Could you just come over here for a second, please?
Stop that! We've got to make contact. One of us should actually try to speak to it.
Good idea. I'm Peter. The usual stuff isn't working.
The usual stuff.
Ready? Get her!
I'm already digging the silliness of this. I was pretty confident that at least this version of Ghostbusters, maybe the second movie too, kind of had, well, all of them might, I don't know, but a level of silliness to it. Comedic.
Hey, Dean Yeager.
I trust you're moving us to better quarters on campus.
No, you're being moved off campus.
Okay.
This university will no longer continue any funding of any kind for your group's activities. Your theories are the worst kind of popular tripe. Your methods are sloppy and your conclusions are highly questionable.
Forget MIT or Stanford now.
Call it luck. Call it karma. I believe that everything happens for a reason.
Me too.
We were destined to get thrown out of this dump. For what purpose?
Maybe they were.
This ecto-containment system that Spengler and I have in mind is going to require a load of bread to capitalize. Where are we going to get the money?
I don't know. Never gonna regret this, Ray.
My parents left me that house. I was born there.
You're not gonna lose the house. Everybody has three mortgages nowadays.
You know what? He's not wrong.
I think this building should be condemned. The wiring is substandard. It's completely inadequate for our power needs. And the neighborhood is like a demilitarized zone.
Hey, does this pole still work?
Yep.
Wow. When can we move in? You gotta try this pole. Should stay here tonight, sleep here, you know, to try it out.
He sounds like a kid. Anyway, I do know this place works out because it is the place. I know the building. I had no idea that she was in this movie. What the heck?
Oh, Dan, it's you.
Oh, hi. Yes, Luz, it's me.
I thought it was a drugstore.
Oh, are you sick?
Oh, no, I'm fine. I feel great. I taped 20-minute workout on my machine and played it back at high speed, so it only took 10 minutes.
I'd really like to, Luz, but I have to go to rehearsal now. Excuse me.
Oh, my gosh. She's so beautiful.
And that reminds me, I'm having a big party for all my clients. My fourth anniversary as an accountant, you know, and even though you do your own tax return, which you shouldn't do, I'd like you to stop by, being that you're my neighbor and all. You shouldn't leave your TV on so loud when you go out. To creep down the hall, phone the manager.
Was it a ghost?
I turned up my TV real loud, too, so everyone would think that both our TVs had something wrong with them. Okay, so I'll see you later, huh?
Rick Moranis is absolutely perfect to play a character like this. Oh, no.
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
You or any of your family ever seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
Ghostbusters.
Wow, they were quick to get an ad out, hey?
We're ready to believe you.
Ghosts like eggs? What is that sound? A what? What?
Everybody can relax. I found the car. Need some suspension work and shocks and brakes, brake pads, linings.
Everything. It needs new everything.
Janine, any calls?
No.
Any messages?
No.
Any customers?
No, Dr. Venkman.
Type something, will you? We're paying for this stuff.
Start writing a novel, Janine.
Bug eyes. Sorry about the bug eyes thing. I'll be in my office.
You're very handy, I can tell. Do you have any hobbies?
I collect spores, molds, and fungus.
Good hobby.
Can I help you?
I don't have an appointment.
I'm Peter Venkman. May I help you?
I don't know. What I have to say may sound a little unusual.
You're in the right place. You're literally in the right place.
And then I slammed the refrigerator door and I left. That was 2 days ago, and I haven't been back to my apartment.
Generally, you don't see that kind of behavior in a major appliance.
Yeah, maybe the building itself has a history of psychic turbulence.
Right, good idea.
I could look for the name Zool in the usual literature.
Spate's catalog.
Tobin's spirit guide.
Tell you what, I'll take Miss Barrett back to her apartment and check her out.
He will probably do both.
If something's gonna happen here, I want it to happen to me first. I hate this. A lot of space.
This is a very nice apartment.
What is that thing you're doing?
It's technical. It's one of our little toys.
That's the bedroom, but nothing ever happened in there.
What a crime.
You know, you don't act like a scientist.
No, he doesn't at all.
Oh my God. Look at all the junk food.
There was a space, and there was a building or something with flames coming out of it, and there were creatures writhing around, and they were growling and snarling.
I'm sorry, I'm just not getting any reading.
Well, are you sure you're using that thing correctly?
I think so, but I'm sure there are no animals in there.
Either I have a monster in my kitchen or I'm completely crazy.
I don't think you're crazy.
Oh, good. That makes me feel so much better.
Yeah, these conversations are a lot of fun so far.
And all I have is my work. There's nothing else in my life.
Dr. Beckman.
I meet you, and I say, my God, there's someone with the same problem I have.
Yes, we both have the same problem. You.
I'm going to go for broke. I am madly in love with you. And then she threw me out of her life. She thought I was a creep. She thought I was a geek, and she probably wasn't the first.
No.
I've got it.
I'll prove myself to you.
Yeah, I'll solve your little problem.
Okay.
I'll bet you're going to be thinking about me after I'm gone.
I bet I am.
No kiss.
No. Don't even know each other. You locked yourself out again? Bro, Lewis, get it together, dude.
Yes, of course they're serious. You do? Uh-huh. Well, just give me the address. We got one!
Let's go. I love that they even set up lockers. That's fun. Ecto-1. There it is. I've seen the car before, too. The car, the theme song, the firehouse. It's the extent of my Ghostbusters knowledge.
Hey,
the outfits. Thanks to the Stranger Things kids for dressing up as literally these guys.
Don't worry. We handle this kind of thing all the time.
I'm curious how many of you that were kids in the 80s, how many of you dressed up as these guys for Halloween?
What are you supposed
Let
to
me
be,
know.
Some kind of a cosmonaut?
No, we're exterminators.
That's gotta be some cockroach.
Bite your head off, man.
It's actually a rad roach from the Fallout world. That would justify all the machinery they have.
You know, it's just occurred to me, we really haven't had a completely successful test of this equipment.
This is your test run.
Each of us is wearing an unlicensed nuclear accelerator on his back.
I love that Peter's just walking so casually in here. The other two are like somewhat prepared at least. Let's not. That's why Peter was like that.
What the hell are you doing?
These two are trigger happy.
Successful test.
I guess so.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Love that the cigarette is just stuck to his lip.
Disgusting blob.
Yeah, what is this?
It's right here, Ray. It's looking at me.
Don't move. It won't hurt you.
Oh.
He slimed me.
That's great.
That's what the goop was in the library, contact. Right?
Spengler, I'm with Venkman. You got slime.
That's great, Ray. Save some for me.
We need a sample.
There it is. On the ceiling. Throw it. I did that.
There's something very important I forgot.
You all
to tell
did
you.
That.
What?
Don't cross the streams. Try to imagine all life as you know it stopping instantaneously and every molecule in your body exploding at the speed of light.
Total protonic reversal.
All right, important safety tip. Thanks, Egon.
I think I trust Egon the most.
Ray!
I love that they seem to hit everything but what they're trying to hit.
There is no problem with the room. It will be ready promptly at time as soon as your guests are with it.
I don't know about that. We've got fire on the walls.
Gotta get this in the clear. Wait.
You always wanted to do this. And?
Good job. Yep, that was beautiful and perfect. Mm-hmm.
Go! Okay.
Oh.
Go!
Here we go.
Working, Ray.
All right, I'm opening that trap now. Don't look directly into the trap.
I looked at the trap, Ray.
Got him.
It's in there.
Hey. Well, that wasn't such a chore, now, was it?
Well, you have some improvement, I think.
We came, we saw, we kicked its ass.
Sir, what you had there was what we refer to as a focused, non-terminal repeating phantasm, or a class 5 full roaming vapor.
Let's talk seriously. Now, for the entrapment, we're going to have to ask you for 4 big ones, $4,000 for that. But we are having a special this...
You didn't talk about prices beforehand?
I had no idea it'd be so much. I won't pay it.
Well, that's all right. We can just put it right back in.
Hope we can help you again. Coming through 1.5 free roaming vapor.
Today, the entire eastern seaboard is alive with talk of incidents of paranormal activity.
Where heck, my grandma used to spin yarns about a spectral locomotive that would rocket past the farm where she grew up.
What does this guy in the back want? Nothing, I guess.
Hi, this is Larry King. The phone-in topic today, ghosts and ghost busting. The controversy...
the cover of Time. Do ghosts have civil rights? Oh my gosh.
No job is too big. No fee is too big.
Is it just the mist? It doesn't...
Look at this. Janine can actually put in some work. Well, here's that sexual content. Oh, boy.
Do you believe in UFOs, astral projections, mental telepathy?
Gosh, I love her earrings.
If there's a steady paycheck in it, I'll believe anything you say.
This is Winston Zedmore. He's here about the job.
Beautiful. You're hired. Ray Stantz, Pete Venkman. Welcome aboard.
I don't know where they get these guest conductors.
Well, I don't think that the man is competent to conduct a major symphony orchestra.
A little reuniting. Let's do it.
That was a wonderful rehearsal.
You heard that?
Yes, you're the best one in your row.
You have some information for me on my case?
Well, sure, but I prefer to give it to you in private.
Why don't you tell me now?
Well, okay, I found the name Zul for you.
Well, the name Zul refers to a demigod worshipped around 6000 BC by the...
Hittites.
Mesopotamians and the Sumerians.
Gozer was very big in Sumeria.
Well, what's he doing in my icebox?
I'm working on that. If we could get together Thursday night, I'm thinking 9-ish.
Smooth.
You seem to think there is something wrong up here that says, in your mind, he enjoys taking his evenings off and spending it with his clients. I respect you. It's corny, but I respect you as an artist.
It is not corny to tell people you respect them. Maybe it was back then, though. I don't know.
So who the hell is that?
He's just a friend.
A friend?
An old friend.
He's just a friend that I think she may be having a little bit of a crush on.
Glad you're feeling much better. You're still very pale, though.
Jeez.
The light is green. Crap is clean. Ghost is incarcerated here in our custom-made storage facility.
Fancy.
The man from the EPA here to see you. He's waiting in your office.
EPA, what's he want?
All I do know is that I've been working 2 weeks without a break, and you promised me you'd hire more help.
She needs a break. She needs time off.
Are you going to answer that?
Quit better jobs than this. Ghostbusters, what do you want?
I represent the Environmental Protection Agency, the 3rd District. Exactly what are you a doctor of?
That was my question.
Well, I have PhDs in parapsychology and psychology.
Okay.
And now you catch ghosts. And how many ghosts have you caught, Mr. Fink? And where do you put these ghosts?
Into a storage facility.
And may I see this storage facility?
No.
Because you did not use the magic word. Please.
Hey, please. See the storage facility.
Why do you want to see the storage facility?
Well, because I'm curious.
And we want to assess any possible environmental impact from your operation. Now, you either show me what is down there, or I come back with a court order.
You go get a court order, and I'll sue your ass for wrongful prosecution.
Let's say this Twinkie represents the normal amount of psychokinetic energy in the New York area. According to this morning's sample, it would be a Twinkie 35 feet long, weighing approximately 600 pounds.
Oh.
That's a big Twinkie.
Yeah.
We could be on the verge of a fourfold cross rip.
Real talk, I don't like Twinkies. Never really have.
We just had a visit from the Environmental Protection Agency. How's the grid holding up?
It's not good.
Yeah, that's a problem. Oh, okay. Was that what was in her fridge? Is that Zool? Oh, man. No.
Oh, Dana, it's you.
He just knows, man.
You're missing a classic party.
Yes, well, I would, Louis, but I have a date.
Oh, no, you're about to break his heart.
You made a date? I'm sorry, Louis, I forgot.
Oh, that's okay. You can bring him along.
All right.
Her face.
That's great. I'll tell everybody you're coming. We're going to play Twist.
Did he lock himself out again?
Him?
Yep. I hope by the end of the movie there's an instance where he opens the door successfully and has not locked himself out.
Bye. Bye.
Something's going on in the kitchen. Go investigate. Or just get Peter out here. Oh my god. Oh my god. Well, I think she's going to miss the date.
I can get 600 tablets of that for the same price as 300 of a name brand. That makes good financial sense. Good advice.
Of course, Lewis would be that guy.
$4.95 a pound. It only cost me $14.12 after tax, though. I'm giving this whole thing as a promotional expense.
I respect it, though, because I'm pretty much like this, too, when it comes to finances and money, budgeting.
I'm going home.
Well, listen, maybe if we start dancing, other people will join in. Ted has a small carpet cleaning business in receivership. They got $15,000 left on the house at 8%.
Oh.
Does anybody want to play Parcheesi? Okay, who brought the dog?
Oh, Jesus. Oh, my gosh. Oh.
Help! There's a bear loose in my apartment, help!
There's a bear. Also, can we just talk about how social this guy is? Like, he had a proper party. Looks like a lot of fun.
Gotta be away in here. I gotta get...
Aww.
You little pooch.
They don't see it?
Hey, what happened?
Some moron brought a cougar to a party.
A cougar to a party. Could have another meaning. Does this not look suspicious at all to you, sir?
Hello.
Oh.
That's a different look for you, isn't it?
Are you the keymaster?
Not that I know of.
Are you the keymaster?
Yeah.
There you go.
I didn't get your name.
My name's Zool. I'm the gatekeeper. We must prepare for the coming of Gozer.
Gozer, huh?
The destructor.
God, she's so hot.
Are we still going out?
Might be staying in now.
You want this body.
Is this a trick question?
I guess the roses worked, huh?
Some creature.
We never talk anymore.
I make it a rule never to get involved with possessed people.
Good rule. Good rule.
Actually, it's more of a guideline than a rule.
Oh, okay.
What you inside me?
Sounds like you got at least two people in there already. What I'd really like to do is talk to Dana.
There is no Dana, only Sewell.
What a lovely singing voice you must have. One.
Oh, gosh.
Please come down.
Sewell's like, no. I don't want to. Oh, my God, that line about how it sounds like there's two in you already. Be too crowded. I loved that.
I am Vince Clortho, key master of Gozer.
Oh no.
Are you the gatekeeper?
Hey, he pulls the wagon. I make the deals. You want to ride?
Wait for the sign, and all prisoners will be released. You will perish in flames.
What an asshole.
Are you the gatekeeper?
You better bring him inside.
So kind to take care of that man. You know, you are a real humanitarian.
Ship the hell out of these two. Oh, well, there we go. Mm-hmm.
What sign are you waiting for?
Gozer the Traveler. He will come in one of the pre-chosen forms.
Something very strange about that.
Duh, yeah.
I'm afraid you're gonna die.
I have some news from the world of Gozer. It seems the Goz has been putting some moves on my would-be girlfriend. I think we can get her a guest shot on Wild Kingdom. She says she's the gatekeeper.
I just met the keymaster. He's here with...
We have to get these two together.
Mm-hmm.
I think that would be extraordinarily dangerous. We have to find Ray. I need him here immediately.
Bad news, honey. I gotta go to work.
Oh, not this guy again.
Step aside, miss, or I'll have you arrested for interfering with the police.
You gotta communicate while you're here. Why you're here?
Cease and desist all commerce order. Seizure of premises and chattels. Ban on the use of public utilities for non-licensed waste handlers.
Damn. He was ultra prepared.
Excuse me, this is private property.
Shut this off. Shut these all off.
You turning off these machines would be extremely hazardous.
I'll tell you what's hazardous. You're facing federal prosecution for at least a half...
Lewis.
Shut that thing down, and we are not going to be held responsible for whatever happens. No, we won't be.
Shut it off.
I've never seen anything like this before. I don't
know. I'm not interested in your opinion. Just shut it off.
Maybe you should be interested in his opinion.
Besides,
if he does that again, you can shoot him.
Do your job, pencil neck. Don't tell me how to do mine.
Thank you, officer.
Shut it off.
Well, we can't say we didn't warn the man, like, 10 times, so. Oh, no.
This is it! This is the sign!
Yeah, it's the sign, all right.
These men are a criminal violation of the Environmental Protection Act, and this explosion is a direct result of it!
Your mother!
Well, this isn't good.
Columbia Building, 57th Street. I'm in a hurry.
Oh, gosh. Ew. Damn, this is a really nice... Like, the apartment itself, beautiful, but, like, that view? Hello?
Cold, riveted girders with cores of pure selenium. Everybody getting this so far? The whole building is a huge superconductive antenna that was designed and built expressly for the purpose of pulling in and concentrating spiritual turbulence. Your girlfriend lives in the corner penthouse of Spook Central.
Makes sense.
Now, we're actually going to go before a federal judge and say that some moldy Babylonian god is going to drop in on Central Park West and start tearing up the city?
Yes.
The mayor wants to see you guys. The whole island's going crazy. Let's go.
I got a split the mayor wants to rap with me about.
This movie's fun. Oh, hi, Lewis.
I am the key master.
I am the gatekeeper.
Where is the thunder coming from?
Where's this Peck?
I am Walter Peck, sir, and I'm prepared to make a full report. These men are consummate snowball artists. They use sense and nerve gases to induce hallucinations.
Oh, my gosh.
Everything was fine with our system until the power grid was shut off by Dickless here.
They caused an explosion.
Is this true?
Yes, it's true. This man has no dick.
Jesus!
This beats the hell out of me.
The walls in the 53rd precinct were bleeding.
Yeah, how do you explain that, sir?
I think it's a sign from God. But don't quote me on that.
No, I think that's the smart move, Mike.
I'm Winston Zeddemore, Your Honor. I've only been with the company for a couple of weeks.
Since I joined these men, I have seen shit that'll turn you white.
Well, you can believe Mr. Becker.
Mr. Becker?
Biblical.
What he means is Old Testament, Mr. Yes. Mayor. Real Wrath of God type stuff. Oh, rivers and seas boiling.
40 years of darkness, earthquakes, volcanoes.
The dead rising from the grave.
What if you're wrong?
If I'm wrong, nothing happens. We go to jail, peacefully, quietly. We'll enjoy it.
We'll enjoy it. Okay.
You will have saved the lives of millions of registered voters.
Good way of putting that.
Get him out of here.
Yay.
Bye.
I'm going to get you a nice fruit basket. I'm going to miss him.
We got work to do.
All right. Mayor's on board. Love to see it. Truly because I think of how Peter worded that. Millions of registered voters.
I like that shirt, Brad.
They are like extremely popular celebrities. Oh. Oh my gosh. These practical effects are great. All of a sudden, I just feel like I've seen the Lego version of that. Yay, they're fine. Well. Oh, that poor piano.
Hey, where do these stairs go?
They go up.
This music is so dramatic. I love it. Oh, gosh.
So, she's a dog.
I love the dialogue in this movie. It's so good. And also, these are not dogs. I mean, they kind of look like them and they kind of sound like them, but they're not.
Girl.
I thought Gozer was a man. It's whatever it wants to be.
Well, whatever it is, it's got to get by us. Go get her, Ray. Gozer the Gozerian, as a duly designated representative of the city, county, and state of New York, I order you to cease any and all supernatural activity and return forthwith to your place of origin.
That ought to do it. Thanks very much, Ray.
Good work.
Are you a god?
No.
Then die.
Oh, dear.
When someone asks you if you're a god, you say yes. This chick is toast.
Let's do it.
Show this prehistoric bitch how we do things downtown. Aim for the flat top!
Oh?
We have the tools, we have the talent.
It's Miller time.
This looks extraordinarily bad.
This doesn't sound great. Watch out below. Let's run. Rocks do not have to be very big for them to do some serious damage to you if it hits you up here.
Who is the form of the destructor?
If we think of J. Edgar Hoover, J. Edgar Hoover will appear and destroy us, okay? So empty your head.
The choice is made.
Whoa, nobody choosed anything.
Nobody choosed.
I couldn't help it.
Oh, boy.
I tried to think.
Look!
No! It can't be.
What?
Oh, no.
It's the Stay Puffed Marshmallow Man.
Oh, my God. I'm actually impressed with how that looks, though.
Something I loved from my childhood.
Uh-huh.
Something that could never, ever possibly destroy us.
Nice thinking, Ray.
Sorry, Beckman. I'm terrified beyond the capacity for rational.
Oh, not this guy. Not fucking Peck again.
Nobody steps on a church in my town.
Oh my God, the face.
We've been going about this all wrong. This Mr. Stay Puft is okay. He's a sailor. He's in New York. We get this guy laid, we won't have any trouble.
Y'all gotta hurry.
We'll cross the streams.
Excuse me, Egon. You said crossing the streams was bad.
You did say that.
There's definitely a very slim chance we'll survive.
Oh, good.
I love this plan. I'm excited to be a part of it.
See you on the other side, Ray. Nice working with you, Dr. Beckman.
Streams are crossed. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. I understand the slim chance of survival now. I love the marshmallow everywhere. Deserved. Absolutely deserved. Okay, we got movement. This is good.
Beckman. Spengler!
Oh, Spengler. Oh, are you okay? I feel like the floor of the taxi cab.
Becky!
I'm all right.
You all right?
I'm all right. You all right?
Yeah. You okay?
Yeah, we're good. What about Dana and Lewis, though? I did see, like, the dog bodies.
Barbecued dog hair.
But...
I'm sorry. I just forgot.
Forgot what? Oh, here we go. Yay! I was like, there's no way they're dead.
Somebody turn on the lights!
Boy, the superintendent's gonna be pissed.
You know, Mr. Tully, you are a most fortunate individual. You have been a participant in the biggest interdimensional cross-rip since the Tunguska blast of 1909.
We'd like to get a sample of your brain tissue.
Oh. Ah, there we go. Love that the movie ends with a kiss. I can't believe... Well, no, I can't, actually. Sorry, I found it interesting that Sigourney Weaver was credited before the third Ghostbuster, but...
Anybody want to interview me? I'm an eyewitness!
All right. All right. Okay, everyone, if you enjoyed my reaction to Ghostbusters, let me know by clicking that like button down below. Thank you so much for watching with me. Let's talk about this. Well, it feels so good to finally have watched this movie, a classic that has been loved by so many for so long. This was far funnier than I thought it would be. I knew going in it was a comedy, of course, and comedy for me, it's tricky. If you've been on the channel long enough, you'll know that I'm pretty picky when it comes to comedy. I just never know if I'm gonna like something or not. It depends on so many factors, but this worked for me. I laughed so much during this movie, as you saw. It was great. The one thing I was not expecting, though, like, I had no idea that this movie had sexual content and humor, and way more than I ever could have predicted. Now listen, 2024 perspective on some 1986 jokes, there are like a couple moments where it was kind of eh, but you know what? Overall, it worked for me. It was a pleasant surprise. I had a good time with it. And I feel like this is one of those movies where if you were a child in the 80s and you watched it back then multiple times and then you rewatched this movie as an adult, probably a night and day difference. For me, that movie is Shrek. I watched Shrek so much as a child, and then as I got older and I revisited it, I was like, whoa, this movie is way more fun as an adult. So I do feel like Ghostbusters can be in that category. You guys let me know. Children of the 80s, you let me know. My favorite character was Lewis. Rick Moranis is Lewis. You could not have put a different actor in that role. Lewis was hilarious to me. I felt like I was looking at myself in the mirror, though, a handful of times. When he got locked out of his apartment multiple times, that's me. I've locked myself out of my house many times in my life. not just this one, but places I lived in previously. I don't know what it is. I think I have my keys on me and I actually don't. And it's kind of embarrassing. So when I was yelling at Lewis to get his shit together, I was actually yelling at myself because I have yelled at myself that every time it happens. So that was fun. And then the conversation when Lewis was talking about like the cost of things and prices and stuff, that's also me because I have been tracking every penny in and out of my life for the last decade and more. And that spoke to me. I loved Lewis. Great character. Sigourney Weaver. So if I have looked at her IMDb in the past, I must have just completely erased the fact that she is in this movie out of my brain. So it was a pleasant surprise to have her appear. And of course, I'm immediately going to root for her character because it's Sigourney Weaver. I love every character she's ever played that I've seen so far. And this movie now is another one of those. She was fantastic, but I think I'll always love every character she is. She was fun. As for our main men, the Ghostbusters themselves, Bill Murray as Peter was definitely my favorite. I feel like his character was kind of pushed to be the more prominent one and the one that's kind of out in front. But for me, the nonchalantness of him was so fun. So many moments. I mean, he clearly cared about what he was doing, but there were so many moments in this movie where it just felt like he did not give a shit. And I kind of loved that. And the deadpan delivery of a lot of his lines was amazing. And there were also so many moments in this movie where it almost felt like the actors themselves were kind of breaking a little bit. I noticed it with Sigourney Weaver a lot, noticed it with Bill Murray quite a bit, but it was like left in, not retaken or anything like that. So I loved that. I just thought it added so much to the characters and their dynamic with each other, and it was fun to watch. Let's chat about the visuals. So, handful of moments in this movie where, yes, obviously it's dated. You can tell it's from the mid-80s. However, this still really holds up well today, and I just enjoyed it. A lot of the practical work was really well done. The street with the cop car sticking out of it, like I said, pretty sure I've seen a Lego set of that before, but that was very cool looking in the moment, especially when you saw the guys all fall into the hole and then climb out of it. Like, that was really well done. I had a good time with that. And even the effects that looked clearly dated, like, I still think were done well, and just, it's very fun to watch. Had a great time with the visuals. The music, well, I mean, we all know that this movie has the best theme song of all time, but everything outside of the theme song, I still really enjoyed. I can't remember now who does the music for this movie. I did see his name at the start, but I don't recognize it. So yeah, the music was great. As for the story, I don't have really any comments about it, which is weird because story is so much of what hooks me into films. But when it comes to comedy, sometimes I don't give a shit about the story. Sometimes I am just invested in what I am watching, like the actual visuals of stuff, and just laughing at all the comedic lines. And that's really it. And that's how I feel about Ghostbusters. Like, they could have been doing anything. They could have been doing anything, and I would have been here for it. Whatever. It was fine. All right, with that, I think that wraps up my thoughts on Ghostbusters. I'm very much looking forward to watching the other four. But before we do that, of course, we have to go to Letterboxd to see what some other people have to say. 5 stars, a movie with no emotional core, no character arcs or growth. No one learns anything. It's not saying anything. It shouldn't work, but somehow it's perfect. No one has been able to replicate it, and they should stop trying. 5 stars, a detail I did not notice before. Venkman and Stans, but not Spengler, are drinking Budweisers when they get their first call at the Sedgwick Hotel. So 2/3 of the Ghostbusters were likely buzzed when they busted their first ghost. That tickled me for some reason. 3.5 stars, proof that a catchy theme song and a team of lovable goofballs can elevate even the most B-movie premise. Just don't get slimed by the plot. All right, everyone, it is now that time of the video where I turn it to you and I ask you to leave your comments down below about Ghostbusters. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know if there's anything that I missed. I'm actually positive that I missed a lot, and we'll probably catch many more things on rewatches in the future, and I cannot wait for that. I love rewatching movies. Always pick up on more. It's always funnier, usually funnier anyway, but I think this movie will get funnier with more and more watches. So yeah, I'm excited to read your comments. Let me know all your thoughts. Thank you so much for watching with me. And if you're not yet subscribed, please click here to do so. And if you want to watch something else of mine, click on over here. Ghost emojis in your comments, leave them below. And we'll see you next time. Take care, everybody.